From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 NOW update.
Good morning and welcome back to News 8 NOW. I'm Tracy Sable. The amount of investigators in New Hampshire town where a young girl went missing decreased dramatically on Thursday. Authorities have shut down the command station at an elementary school in West Stewartstown where they were searching for Selena Cass. The 11-year-old's body was pulled from the Connecticut River Monday, nearly a week after she disappeared from her home. An autopsy failed to find a cause of death, and toxicology tests are pending. At the height of the search, more than 100 state and federal investigators were headquartered at the community school. The investigation is continuing. Some Maine counties won't get any money through the United Way for emergency food programs, and it's all thanks to federal budget cuts. The Root Cellar in Portland is one of those food pantries. The faith-based organization gets $10,000 to $12,000 to help out with its weekly food distribution, but not this year. On a national level, funding for the emergency food and shelter program was cut almost in half of the most recent budget. To figure out who got what, the formula for counties to qualify changed. Based on the 2000 census poverty data, in total, six Maine counties were left with zero federal funding.
Many of them last year had to reduce the amount of food that they could give to families, the number of times that they could help people. So if that was happening last year with this loss of funds, I can only imagine that it will get significantly worse.
We won't help any fewer families. They might, if anything, they would walk out with a little bit less in their basket. That's what it would be.
The Root Cellar also says that it may have to cut back on more pricey foods like healthy produce. And because the budget wasn't approved until April, many food pantries did not find out until about a week ago that they were not getting any federal funding. A change is already made because of the Affordable Health Care Act, and changes that are planned for next year could add up to some serious savings at the doctor's office. The new regulations, including prohibiting insurance companies from charging a co-payment, co-insurance, or a deductible for certain well-visit care and vaccinations. Next year, the law will change again to eliminate co-pays for prescription contraception, as well as certain procedures and counseling related to women's health. Some doctors say reducing obstacles to get patients, especially children, to their office is a very positive thing.
It's wonderful. I mean, it's one less barrier to getting kids and families in to where we can really help prevent disease and optimize their experience, optimize their health.
Well, some organizations, however, are against the broad use of contraceptives, so they're not happy with the changes announced for next year. Some women's health advocates say the move will reduce the number of unwanted pregnancies and abortions. Well, a group of Central Maine Power ratepayers has filed a complaint with state regulators about the utility's use of so-called smart meters. The 19-person complaint filed with the Maine Public Utilities Commission challenging CMP's smart meter program, which CMP is replacing 600,000 traditional electric meters with wireless digital devices. After reviewing other complaints, the PUC voted in May to allow CMP customers to opt out of using the meters, but at a cost of $12 a month. The new complaint asks CMP to stop installing those meters or at least make them an option at no cost. CMP says those smart meters are safe. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. Tracy Sable will be right back.